Hi all, this is Ashish Kyal here. Welcome again to Ashish Kyal Trading Gurukul, learning series by wavestrategy.com. And aaj main baat karunga fundamental ratio ki, jo price to earning ratio kehte hai. I'm going to speak about a fundamental ratio, which is known as price to earning ratio. And I'm sure you might be thinking, what will a technical analyst talk about price to earning ratio? Aisa nahi hai. There is so much that you can make out from a fundamental parameter if you can only plot it and see it on the chart what's happening around. So let me just share that my presentation with you, which talks about this price to earning ratio. And let me just move on. Okay, over here, if you can see this chart over here, you will be able to understand that the overall, okay, you will be able to understand that the overall trend of this price to earning ratio had been in a range. It's always that's the case. Ye jo blue line aap dekh rahe, this is price to earning ratio, and it has always moved within this range. And if you make out on the downside, this is the extreme level of the range. Theek hai, yahan par what you see, this as a around 20 ke aaspas, this is the median reading. Now median has also shifted upside because of this extreme reading. Now price to earning ratio को plot कर दिया, so you call it technical or fundamental, up to you. For me, what is important is how do I use this information. Now this orange line is nothing but Nifty. This blue line is nothing but price to earning ratio. Now we can clearly see that over past 20-22 years, price to earning ratio extreme reading had been around 29. Extreme, I am saying 29. Suppose that market had a correction from 2000 onwards for a period of 3 years. 29, suppose that market had a correction of nearly 60% from there in 2008. 26, from there the market had a correction for almost a year and more. And over here we can clearly see that it is just 29, post which we had a parched pandemic sell-off. Now you might wonder ki phir baad mein we touched 42 levels, aise kaise possible ho gaya? Matlab, we broke all those extremities and touched 42, and price to earning continued to come down despite Nifty rallying, which is opposite, right? Generally nahi hota. Price to earning matlab kya hua? Prices divided by earnings per share. Now prices rally ho raha hai, okay, so price to earning ratio bhi upar jana chahiye, lekin price to earning niche aa raha hai. Aisa kyun? Now this is happening because the overall price to earning ratio is coming down, because you can see that the earnings have suddenly jumped post the lockdown open started in 2020. Uske baad mein kya hua? Suddenly kya hua? The lockdown happened. Because of that, earnings suddenly started falling. That resulted into shoot up in the price to earning ratio. As soon as the lockdown opened, price to earning ratio came down because earnings shot up drastically. So it's like a spring. We were compressing because of the lockdown. Suddenly the spring unwounded because lockdown opened up, earnings suddenly jumped, and now we will normalize in a range. So even in this normalization, if you see that the price to earning ratio is still currently quoting at 27 reading, which is near the highs that we saw in March. We saw it in 2011, we saw it in 2008, we saw it in 2000 also. So is this the market for investors? No, this is not the market for investors right now. Looking at this price to earning ratio, if the earnings continues to be exorbitant from here on for next 2 quarters, then this earnings will start coming down, provided prices does not increase. So wo hoga tabhi ye valuation, fair valuation पे हम बोलेंगे कि market आ गया, लेकिन now I think it is a stretched valuation from that perspective. So remember one thing, in this stretched valuation you should never trade with complacency, you should trade with caution. लेकिन market trend अभी भी ऊपर है, there is no support that is broken. So this is purely from investing from next 2 years, 3 years, 1 year perspective I am talking about. But as a trader, don't use it and start selling the market tomorrow. Okay, you need to understand certain more concepts before you do that. Fantastic guys, so I thought I'll just explain you this simple parameter. This indicates we are still at the extremes that we have saw in the past. It's not a good reading, it's an extreme reading. The day Nifty breaks support level, it will indicate something is changing in the market, but for now, buy on dips as a momentum trade, you can do that. Okay, that's pretty clear about it. Just ensure this is purely from educational perspective. We are nowhere recommending you to buy, sell, or do any such thing. This is Ashish Kalyar. You can get in touch with me on this number. Follow me on Twitter and YouTube channel @KalAshish with your queries and doubts. I'll be more than happy to address them and help you with any queries that you might have. So I'll just quickly take off from here and see you again soon. Thank you.